Well, the heroic architect is absolutely the firefighting example from design, or it could be the heroic engineer, although honestly they tend to have their act together better than many designers. And what ends up happening is that you have you generate a sketch, for instance, for a layout or for a facade or something like that. And the thing that can sometimes happen is that you take it in front of the client, and despite your best efforts, they just simply say no. And what ends up happening then is that people use that as an excuse to not plan their work, to not bring that work further forward and start on it sooner, because they figure that, hey, you know what, it could all fall apart, therefore it can't be planned, it can't be optimized. And so what I try to help people focus on is that positive iteration is a wonderful tool, and that you can create better results with better design inputs. And typically people tend to understand that and to get on board with that. And what that means is that if you're going to have more inputs, higher quality inputs, you can't wait until the last night and then do your own work at a desk or a table late at night and then show up and be the hero, because other people don't have time to respond to that, and you don't have time to iterate. You don't have time to take that sketch that solves at a basic level and make it into something that truly sings. And so from the perspective of firefighting, that's our firefighting, is the tendency to go off and do this creative work, this in a tortured soul kind of manner. And we need to bring that into the light of day, and we need to open that up. And that can truly be scary. People are very reluctant to put forth personal work to critique, because that takes a level of confidence and assurance that not everybody has all the time.